guys, it's Haffina back in, and I am doing an Empties video today, if you're wondering about this makeup look. It was probably my last video. So I will link that somewhere, so you can go and have a look if you're curious. I am not really keeping running totals of my Empties this year, although I am writing them down in case I change my mind later on. And I'm not really keeping stuff from projects separately, so if they're in a project, they would just... I won't have to show them in the project. It's just how it is this year. So, not as well organised as I'd like to be. First up, I have a box of the Dazo cotton puffs that come in the box. I buy these boxes in two packs. There's 180 in there. I think it's like $3.80 or something. They are rectangular in shape, which I quite like. Particularly for nail stuff, that's what I prefer. Every time I go into Dazo, I buy a box of these. So, yeah, I'd buy them again. Also, from Dazo, I have the round ones. These come in a bag. There are 160 of them. Again, this is one of those things I tend to buy every time I go into Dazo. And also from Dazo is the rectangular ones that come in the bag. There's 150 in this. The main difference I feel between the two different rectangular types is one of them comes in a cardboard box. Cardboard box is better for recycling than plastic. So that's really the only difference between them. I sometimes buy these ones, but I prefer the ones in the box, even if I think the ones in the box are slightly more expensive, but they come in a box, so I can recycle the box more effectively than the plastic. But yeah, they're fun. I have from I Love the Minty Choco Chip Body Wash. This smells like mint choc chip. It is pretty accurate to that particular smell. I did get a little bored with it. This is a 750ml. I got a bit bored after a while. I usually have two or three different body washes going at the same time because I get bored with the smells really, like, quickly. So, that's that. Garnier Skin Active. This is the oil infused cleansing water. This is the biphase one. You have to shake it up before you use it. It has like a layer of yellowy coloured oil on it. This was my preferred one for removing eye makeup, so I would use this to remove eye makeup and then use a fake swipe to wipe off the rest of my makeup, and then either this or a different micellar just to re-go over everything. So yeah, it's fine. I would probably buy it again, but only if it was on sale, because it's a little bit more expensive than some of the others. From La Cura, which is the Audi brand, I have the makeup setting spray. They were selling it at one point. It's fine. I don't think it particularly makes your makeup last any longer, but it does help settle down like powders and stuff like that. So yeah, it was fine. They don't really sell it anymore. They have this weird thing with Audis where they'll have like a product and you'll buy it like 1 month and then the next month it's not there and you never ever see it again. I also have the brush cleaner that looks almost exactly the same, but I haven't really used that one. Also from La Cura we have the Paradise Luxury Hand Cream. I can't remember what this smells like. Oh, it smells nice. Sort of a perfumey kind of scent. Orange peel and papaya with cocoa butter and shea butter. It is sort of a florally fruity type of scent. Probably more floral than fruity. Which is fine. I prefer more fruity than floral. But it was fine. And it's a good hand cream. And I enjoyed using it. And I enjoyed the smell. So, yeah. That I would buy it again, but I've never seen this one again. Also from La Cura, I have the detoxifying cleansing wipes with charcoal. These were black in colour. I didn't think that they were any more or less effective than any other makeup wipe I've used from Audi. So, yeah, not my favourite, but they're not terrible. So, yeah. From Tilly, we have the Vanilla Bean Hand and Nail Cream. I'm pretty sure that this was in a project. It doesn't really remind me of vanilla. It's a little too sweet. It's like a really sweet vanilla-y type of scent. Like an overly sweet ice cream. It's kind of weird, but it was fine. It was a decent hand cream. I got this in a Bella box or something. I wouldn't seek it out. I have a Dove Daily Moisturizing Shampoo. There was a shampoo and a conditioner. I think I already had used up the conditioner. I'm not sure. I might not have even used the conditioner yet. I don't remember. It's fine. It's just a shampoo. There's nothing special about it. This is the Cetaville Suntivity 50 Plus High Protection Face Moisturizer Lotion thing. I don't really like this very much. You can use it on your face and body. I'd probably be more inclined to use it on my body. I did use this sample up on my face. I'm not really keen on the very strong scent of sunscreen on my face, which is what this smells like. It literally smells like sunscreen because it's such a high rating. I'd love to know how they managed to get that SPF rating through Australian regulations, because Australian regulations are really tough on that kind of thing. Yeah. But it's not something that I would seek out. Then I have the NSI Attraction Liquid. This is the monomer that I use for my acrylic nails. This is the brand I have been using ever since I started training, so like 3 years. I know how it works. It doesn't have MMA, which is the bad thing. Yeah, it's fine. it's what I prefer, it's what I use. It's one of the less stinky versions of monomer. So there's that. It's also the brand that my lecturer actually preferred, even though that is not the brand that comes in the kit that you would normally buy to do the acrylics course. I bought my kit separately from a different supplier off my own bat. So there's that. Yeah, so I buy this all the time whenever I need it. I have the e.l.f. Lip Scrub in Mint. Done at the point where it scratches your lip when you put it over there. I was actually not a fan of this. I thought I'd really like the mint one. I don't. It's fine. I find the original one better. I didn't really find that this actually was scrubby enough to get the dry skin off my lips. Not quite exfoliating enough. So yeah, I would not buy this one again. I would rather go with either like an indie sugar scrub or the e.l.f. original one of these. And then I have three decluttery things. One of them is my Beauty Big Bang stamper. I have a few stampers, but this stamper, whilst stamping my friend's nails, somehow or another ended up, but it has a big crack in it, and it was affecting how it stamped, and it was so annoying, and I'm not sure how it happened, and at first it was really small, and it just kept on getting bigger and bigger and bigger, so I decided I'm just going to get rid of it and not fuss about it. I have this nail polish, which was in a Swatch My Collection video. It's consistency inside the packaging is really, really weird. It smells really terrible. And yeah, I don't love it enough to try to salvage it or anything, so it is going. And the last thing I have is a blush. This is a blush duo. This is from Smooch. It's called Peachy. It has started breaking and crumbling and cracking. Yes, I depotted it. But it's just driving me mad. It's just going everywhere in the Z palette that it was in. So I've just decided I have enough blush that getting rid of one of them is not going to make any difference. Yeah. So, and I don't love this enough to, like, try and salvage it. So, yeah, this one is going as well. And that is it for this Empties video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you want to subscribe, click the button down there. Click the little bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. Leave me a thumbs up if you like Empties videos. And leave me a comment down below. I try to like, if not respond, to all comments. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.